In 1997, the Corinthian spirit had been replaced by a cool professionalism as a new breed took on the race for the first time, and few epitomized the mood more than Paul Cayard.
We just were very inexperienced. We had 9 people like myself who were America's Cup sailors or star sailors on the boat, but we had our own style. When that all clicked and came together, yeah, I won't ever forget that.
We had a fresh approach. You know, we just upped the game at every level. Clothes, food, stacking, every level, we just pushed it harder.
He come from an Olympic background where you race around short courses, just a mile long, where every centimetre and millimetre counts. He took that same level of obsession and applied it to 30,000 miles of racing around the world.
As the dot-com revolution took hold, the race was followed like never before. Millions around the world took to their computers to check the latest updated positions, living every mile of the race. It was Cayard's bunch of inshore racers on EF language who had the edge on that first leg, leading the fleet into Cape Town by almost a day. Cayard seemed like the real deal, but there was still much to learn. As the rest of the fleet ploughed northwards on the long ride back to Southampton, Cayard and EF language tightened their grip on the race lead with 5 podium places out of 7 stages. The Whitbread had been a 9-leg marathon, visiting more ports than ever before. And with it, Paul Cayard had taken communication to a new level, sharing his victorious lap of the planet with a legion of new fans.
You know, when I went around the world in 97, 98, that was a voyage. It was a lot more than just the race. That was a lifetime experience to sail around the planet on the vehicle that I've spent my whole life on, a sailboat.